Just hear those sleigh bells jingling, ring, ting, tingling too. Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you. Outside the snow is falling and friends are calling you. Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you.
Good morning, Woodstock.
I'm Abby Scoris.
And I'm Alex Manser.
I'm looking forward to Christmas break.
Me too.
What'd you ask for Christmas?
I asked for money. What did you ask for?
I asked to play the next video by Riley and Taylor. Let's find out what Woodstock wanted.
Hey, Woodstock. Christmas is fast approaching.
And so are we. We're going to ask you
what you want for Christmas.
Yes.
What do you want for Christmas?
A PS5. Don't we all?
Sleep.
Me too.
I unfortunately don't celebrate Christmas.
What do you want in general?
Like for Hanukkah?
Yeah.
Probably like a new pair of shoes or something.
Me too.
A corgi puppy.
And what would you name it?
Tater Tot.
Nice. What do you want for Christmas?
Hot wings.
You should go to game day.
I like Buffalo Wild Wings better.
A car.
Vroom.
A big pile of cash.
Don't we all?
I don't really know, but I like Buffalo Wild Wings. So, Buffalo Wild Wings gift card.
What do you want for Christmas?
All I want for Christmas is to know what they want. And, what do you want?
This isn't how it worked, cut. Well,
Woodstock.
Now
we
know
what
you
want
for
Christmas.
But what do you want for Christmas?
I want to see the anchors. Back to you, anchors.
Well, I guess Riley and Taylor got what they wanted for Christmas.
I hope I get what I want for Christmas. But you know what else I want? I want to get to know Mr. Hunter.
Mr. Hunter is a new teacher here at Woodstock. Alden put together a video highlighting what he does here.
The people that you meet each day.
Good morning, Woodstock. Today I got the opportunity to talk to Mr. Hunter, a computer science teacher at Woodstock High School.
I am currently working on my master's at KSU. I have a bachelor's degree from there. I originally went to school at Georgia Tech for biomedical engineering, but I enlisted into the Army after 9/11 and had a long pause before I went back to KSU to get my teaching degree. When I was growing up, I had a few really great teachers who I felt listened to students and made a real impact. I wanted to be like them, and one of them ended up being a professor over at KSU who teaches teachers now. So I was back at KSU deciding what to finish my degree in. I ran to him, and he was like, why don't you follow your dream? As part of student teaching, I taught about 4 different schools as a student teacher, just practicing in different places. This was the final one, and this is where I did my longest stint student teaching. I really liked it here. The students here are very impressive. The community is so supportive of the school, and the administration is great. I like a lot of teachers that I work with, consider them friends, and I enjoy coming here. So this year I teach 2 levels of computer science courses. I teach the introduction course, IDT, and I also teach the second year course, Computer Science Principles. Those are the only 2 classes for computer science that I'm teaching this year. So before going back to college, I was in the Army. I retired from there as a medical retirement. I got injured during my time in the Army. I was in the Army for 13 years. They reconstructed my right foot and reconstructed my back. It took care of a few other things. Because of all the injuries, I was very lucky. The Army gave me a retirement after 13 years of service. So I'm considered retired and get a chance to go back and be a teacher.
Thanks, Mr. Hunter, for your service and for becoming a teacher here at Woodstock. We love your class.
We would also like to thank Lucas for doing a great job on the morning announcements.
Aiden Cole had an opportunity to meet with Lucas and find out how he became the voice of Woodstock High School. Let's take a look.
Hello, Woodstock. You may have noticed a new voice this year giving the morning announcements.
Good morning, Woodstock High School. May I have your attention for the morning announcements?
I would like you all to meet Lucas in this exclusive WTV7 interview.
So, Lucas, how did you end up as the new announcer for Woodstock High School and for the Pledge of Allegiance?
You see, I was reading a passage one day, and Mr. Logan and Ms. Henson thought it would be a great idea for me to start reading the announcements over the intercom, and I thought it would be a great idea too. So I got to do the pledge first, and then after I did the pledge first, I did the full announcements.
Wow, and so now they just have you doing it every day?
Yep, they are having me do it every day.
If you will please stand and join us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
Lucas closed the interview reminding us all what makes Woodstock High School simply the best of the best.
My favorite part of being here at Woodstock High School is seeing all my friends that I get to see every day and coming to work here every day. Yeah, that's what I like about Woodstock High School.
All right, thank you, Woodstock High School. This was Lucas.
Back to you, anchors.
Hey, Woodstock, it's Peyton Robson. I'm happy we got to know a little more about Lucas. He's doing a great job. I know we have exams next week, but we do have some sports that we'll be playing over the break. If you get an opportunity, please support the girls and boys basketball team, the wrestling team, or attend a swim meet and support your Wolverines. Connor, Aiden, and Jackson got an opportunity to watch the boys team play earlier this week. Here are some highlights.
To our boys basketball team tonight at 7:30 at Cherokee.
I know Woodstock is thankful for our basketball teams this year. Landon and Brody went around Woodstock to ask what else you guys are thankful for.
I'm Landon Pope for WTV7, and today we're going to ask you what you're thankful for. So what are you thankful for?
I'm thankful for being alive at 57 years old.
Nice. So what are you thankful for?
I'm thankful for my friends and Jesus.
I am thankful for my family, my husband, my children. I'm thankful for this job that I have, the students and the great teachers I get to work with, and for good health.
So what are you thankful for?
I'm thankful for my friends and family.
I'm thankful for my family and, of course, my family here at Woodstock. It's been an amazing year so far. Let's end it with a bang.
Nice. So what are you thankful for?
I'm thankful for my Lightning McQueen Crocs.
Radical. So, what are you thankful for? Interesting. Well, Woodstock, we now know what you're thankful for. Back to you, anchors.
Well, I hope everyone gets what they wanted for the holidays.
Good luck on your exams next week. Happy holidays, and happy last broadcast of 2021.
Make it a great day, Woodstock.